This year's Nobel Prize in Chemistry went to three scientists, David Baker, John Jumper, and Demis Hassabis, for their groundbreaking work using artificial intelligence to advance biomedical and protein research. The AI model they developed, called AlphaFold, uses databases with hundreds of thousands of protein structures and millions of protein sequences to predict and even design protein structures, speeding up a months or years-long process to mere hours or even minutes. AlphaFold was rolled out just 4 years ago and has since been cited in scientific studies more than 20,000 times. Joining us now from London is Demis Hassabis, co-founder and CEO of Google DeepMind and recipient of the Nobel Prize in Chemistry. Demis, congratulations and welcome.
Thanks so much. Great to be here.
So first and foremost, what did you think when you heard the news?
Well, I was totally stunned, to be honest, and it still hasn't really sunk in even now, 24 hours later. So it just feels very surreal.
So I'm going to try here in simplest terms, which is not simple at all, but to condense the work you and your colleagues have done. Basically, you and your colleague John Jumper discovered new and powerful ways to not only decode, but also design proteins using artificial intelligence. I'm not even going to try to understand the details of your work, but in terms of application, how could this impact future development of things like medicine and vaccines? What does it mean?
Well, proteins are the kind of building blocks of life, really. So everything, all the functions of that own your body are kind of supported by proteins. And it's really important to understand their structure, their 3D structure, so that you can understand what the function is they have. And so that's what AlphaFold, our program, does. It predicts that 3D structure just from the genetic sequence. And it's going to be really important for things like drug discovery and understanding disease.
There was one scientist who reacted to the news of your award by calling your work the Holy Grail in terms of what it's been able to do. Do you agree with that characterization?
Well, it's very nice of them to say so. I mean, it's certainly a grand challenge. I mean, the reason it caught my attention is it's been a kind of grand challenge of biology for the last 50 years. So people have been predicting since the 70s that this should be possible, but until now, no one has been able to do it to an accuracy high enough that it's useful for biologists and medical experts.
So just in your background, you co-founded DeepMind back in 2010. But before that, I was interested to read you designed video games. Before that, you were a chess prodigy. You were once even ranked the second highest player in the world under the age of 14. How did those endeavors, chess and gaming, feed into this work today?
Well, there's a connection all the way through my career, even though I've done different things. So it's because of gaming and chess specifically that I got started to think about thinking. And I was trying to improve my own thought processes, as you do when you're playing chess for, you know, the junior teams and the national junior teams and things like that. And I was playing it very professionally. And part of that training, you also use chess computers, very early chess computers in the 80s. They were actually physical blocks of plastic that you had to press the keys on. And I was sort of intrigued by the fact that someone had programmed this, you know, inanimate object to actually play chess and play chess well. And that's what got me into AI. And then I studied neuroscience as well as computer science, tried to understand better how our own brains work and how intelligence is produced and the mechanisms behind it. And then finally, that all comes together with the work we've been doing on AI.
As you well know, one of your fellow laureates this year is a man named Jeffrey Hinton, who's often called the godfather of AI. He resigned from Google last year, and he's really been sounding the alarm on what he says are the potential dangers here, that, as he puts it, he worries that the overall consequences of this might be systems that are more intelligent than us that might eventually take control. Do you share that concern?
You know, I've known Jeff, we've been colleagues for many, many years, and he's a fantastic scientist. And, you know, I think that my view is sort of more moderate than that. I feel like, of course, I work my whole life on AI because I think it's going to be unbelievably beneficial to humanity and to society. You know, AlphaFold is just, I think, the first expression of that. And, you know, I think we can go on next to try and cure many terrible diseases. I think it can help with climate crisis, new materials, new energy sources, new mathematics. I think AI is going to accelerate scientific discovery, medical discovery across the board. So those are just some of the benefits I think AI is going to bring and why I've worked my whole life on AI. So it's going to be this hugely transformative technology. But as with any new powerful technology, and perhaps AI will be the most powerful, that comes with risks, attendant risks as well, and unknowns. And some of those are to do with controllability, understanding these systems, interpreting what they do, and how to manage the, you know, what are the values we want these systems to have? What do we want to use them for? How do we want to deploy them? And some of these questions are technical in nature, technical challenges, and others are more societal and need discussion with the whole of society, civil society, academia, as well as the tech companies and industrial labs, and also government. And I've been encouraging all of those debates to happen. And it's great that it's starting to see those things happen. And I think given enough time and effort, we will solve these challenges. I'm a big believer in human ingenuity, but we need to start discussing and researching those things now.
That is Demis Hassabis, co-founder and CEO of Google DeepMind and recipient of this year's Nobel Prize in Chemistry. Demis, thank you and congratulations again.
Thank you very much.